Writers, writers and everyone, it is the best way for going into the audience. Thank you.
You know, a lot of celebrities, they have been having accounts either in Facebook or in Twitter, like Amitabh Bachchan, Shahid Tharoor, all Bollywood stars and singers, politicians. They have been using this social network group to promote themselves. You are right. Now, Mr. Patel, I have a question. How it addresses the other issues?
The social networking addresses important issues by the way of how the people interact to each other. If suppose the two friends are interacting with each other, they will be cover all the matters which are happening in their surroundings. Suppose recently a daily rape case has been take place. The people have gathered in one place through this social networks only because someone has seen the happenings and they have just posted the matter in the social network. So through this social network, the friends and family members and other people can connect each other, and this highlights that matter in the social networks.
Okay, this is one platform, my dear friends, to express the anger of the people. People have been using Facebook or Twitter. Mr. Patel mentioned about the recent December 16th incident happened in New Delhi. I would like to remind you one more incident which dethroned the president of Egypt, Hosni Mubarak. People gathered at Tahrir Square and they expressed anger against the government, and because of their anger, the president was removed from the post, and the platform is the people have used Facebook or Twitter, one of the social networking groups. Sandhya, next question to you. As a student, how do you use this social network group?
Firstly, the reason which I have opened my Facebook account is we are having, Physics Sir has opened a knowledge spreading society for you. It was a science related site which we are having in the Facebook. He is going to upload that. I have came to know that information and I have opened my account. In the same way, in the worldwide, there are many such sites promoting students for education, such as Term Wiki and Teach Street and everyone. And moreover, I can support that. The best example is which was taken in the Portland. A school has started a special media program, social media program through this social networking, and it has found wonderful results that 50% of the students were increased in their knowledge in attending the classes and their grades went up through this kind of social networking. That means they are providing the students to get information to interact with their teachers. So I think this is the one of the best platform for the students.
Okay, thank you. Ramya, do you have any experience of using social network for your benefit of academics?
Yes, sir. When I'm studying my PG, my sir, cell biology, who is dealing cell biology, he went off. So we have missed that syllabus actually. Then when we call him, he said that I have put the notes in the network. So you can go and take it off. So we enter into the social network site, then we collect the data from him. So in my real life, it is very helpful.
Okay, thank you. My dear friends, there are many useful websites, social networking groups in the internet, which you can derive a lot of benefits as a student to learn your subject contents. For example, those who are interested in physics, they can open website physics.org and also physics, fearoffysics.com, and you can join as a member in this social networking group, and the group will clarify your doubts related to physics. Similarly, if you have any doubts on mathematics, there is another forum called mathforum.com. So when you have a problem, a difficult problem in mathematics, when you post a problem in the net, across the world, all the members of the group, they will read your problem and they will give you a lot of solutions. Not one solution, sometimes you will get more than one solution. So this is one advantage to the students if they use social network for your benefit to raise your standards in academics. Okay. Next, Daniel. I'm a businessman, suppose, in case if I'm a business, how can I use social networking to promote my business?
Definitely, sir. We can develop our business even through social networking. Recently, in my research, I came to know that you all will be aware of that, Industrial Development Bank of India. It has 5 lakh fans on Facebook. This shows how it is useful. And ICICI, Industrial Credit Investment Corporation of India, it is providing the basic services to the on the base of social networking sites. So definitely, one businessman can definitely use these social networking sites to promote his business to higher levels.
Yeah, thank you. Even Daniel told you about IDBay. I say ICICI Bank also has Facebook account, and they are doing net banking through Facebook also. So business networks have been using to promote their brands through these social networks, say for example Facebook. Okay. And my general question to everyone, do you think, are there any other benefits, positive benefits about social networking? Yes, Sandhya.
Yes, sir, definitely we are having a lot of impact, and this kind of social networking has created an impact on the society. One thing is, the many of the students, even many other people, are using this for social good. Such as we can have sites such as K2, Wiser Earth. They are going to promote the social good, and even although Center for Disease has spread the importance of vaccination through this children's site widely. That is, they are using this for health awareness. And one of the best example is we have seen in the Kuala Lumpur in September 2009. They have created a festival known as Twistival, which is the combination of Twister, Twitter plus Festival. That is, they have organized this for creating an awareness regarding water crisis. And they have collected nearly $2 lakh for eradicating this problem, and they have dug wells across the Africa and solved those problems. So this is one of the good things they have done. I think social networking sites are promoting social good.
Okay, thank you for sharing information. And also I would like to share, social networking is not only used to express anger, like in Delhi, December 16th incident, also Tahrir Square in Egypt, but also positively, it is well utilized by the social network account holders. For example, when Yuvraj Singh is affected with cancer, many of his fans posted speedy recovery, and it gave him a moral boost and developed confidence in him. Maybe due to fans' prayers, he recovers soon from cancer. And also, the man of white revolution, Kurian, when Kurian died, no news channels or newspapers paid much attention, but when you opened social network groups, many posted of the greatness of the Kurian, the man of white revolution, the past chairman of National Dairy Development Board, Anand, in Gujarat. Now, I heard a lot of advantages about social networking from you panel members. Now, I want to ask you, are there any disadvantages? First with Patel. Do you feel... Are there any disadvantages of having an account in social networking?
Yes, sir. I support you, Ms. Social networking in nowadays is becoming an addiction to the youth and all peoples in the world, because the people are not understanding the value of the social network, but just using the for the sake of showing others. It's just a show off to in front of all the peoples. And social networking is addiction because today, nowadays the people who are opening the social networking sites, they are using for unnecessary purpose. They are not sharing the ideas, but they are using for the gossiping and chatting purposes for unusual, unnecessary topics. Suppose what I am wearing, what I am drinking, just is all unnecessary. But they will use these networks for sharing these type of ideas. So just like an addiction, and the people who are using it, they are making it as a part of their life. So without even 1 second, they can't live without it. So it's just like an addiction in front of youth and all the peoples.
So I remember a quotation from a famous psychologist Carl Jung. He said that addiction is anything that you use in excess. Not only alcohol or drugs. Had he lived today, he would have added social networking as also an addiction. Maybe in future, we may need de-addiction centers across the world to remove this bad habit from the, especially from the children and youth who glued their eyes, seats in front of the laptops and the computers hours together and doing nothing, especially this is most unproductive thing. That is one negative point about social networking. Okay, and to continuing negative points, the Soundarya. Can you tell me one more disadvantage of social networking?
One of the disadvantages, what many of them claims, is the privacy issues. Social networking sites, many of them say that they are unable to provide proper facility to their data. I don't want to say what are the privacy issues, as we all know that cyber stalking, bullying and everything. I will say the reason for this kind. What I think is that, you know, every social networking site is used by the immature individuals. That means most of the people are unaware of that there are privacy settings in their account. If they are not known to their privacy settings, how can they restrict the users from those unauthorized access? If they are aware of the privacy settings and they have proper access, because it is the persons whom we choose that who would see our account, who would contact us. So when we take a little care, then these privacy issues can be solved.
Yeah, I agree. This is one negative aspect, especially students who have accounts in social networking like Facebook or Twitter. One dangerous thing is when you reveal your private information, that will be used by a third person, and that third person may blackmail you based on your information. This is a dangerous thing. All students, please keep in your mind, when you operate social networking groups, do not reveal your private information to the public. This is one thing. Ramya, do you have any other negative points?
Yes, sir, definitely. And the other negative point is trolling. Trolling is nothing but the emotionally abused or hurting others. For example, recently October 18 in Chennai, one lady called Chinmayi, he had trolling against his caste and vulgar talks about her. So he gave a police complaint, and at last the culprit had caught by the police. And like these, so many incidents are taking place by using social networking.
Yes, she is right. This incident happened and reported in the newspaper The Hindu also. Chinmayi, her name, and one person abused emotionally in one of the social networks by her caste and gender. And when she gave complaint to the police found the culprit and they put him behind the bus. So my dear students, this is another danger thing called trolling. Trolling means people will emotionally abuse you using tedious language, slang, or whatever you call. They will use all kinds of vulgar language to abuse you. This is one dangerous thing. Be aware of this. And Daniel, continuing these negative points, what else you have in your mind about social networking?
Sometimes the social networking spreads the negative sentiments in the people. Recently, we came to know that the people belonging to the Assam state, they are spread over the whole country, isn't it? But suddenly, all of a sudden, they started to walk to their own Assam state because they saw some rumor on the Facebook. Later on, the police came to know that it was one of the Pakistani person who has done that in the social networking, one of the social networking. So sometimes there is a chance of spreading these kind of negative sentiments. So one should, so a person who uses this this social networking site should be very careful while revealing his privacy issues or any other thing. So there is a chance of spreading negative sentiments.
Thank you. Normally we see bullies in the colleges and schools. I don't know. Do you find bullies, cyberbullying is there in social networking?
Yes sir, cyberbullying is also nowadays takes place. Cyberbullying means blackmailing others with the help of some vital information given in the social networks. Suppose if I have posted some valuable information in the social network, some third person may take advantage and try to earn lump sum of money from me in base of that information. And some people may spread some illogical rumors in the social network sites, and it's just like a hub of all the hackers and unauthorized persons in social network. So we have to be aware of that people's in the network before using it. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you. I think time is running out here. So you might have understood, when you use the social network, there are advantages and disadvantages. And you heard there are advantages. One is it is very inexpensive. You need not become a member in Rotary Club or Lion Club like that. You can become a member of any social network without paying a penny, single penny. That is one advantage. Second advantage is it really helps real life social skills. That is the second advantage. Third advantage, you can create a positive image about yourself and you can promote yourself, you can promote your business, you can download a lot of information. You can download a lot of information related to your academics. As a student, it is very beneficial to you. So there are many advantages. At the same time, there are disadvantages also. Number one, you should not reveal your private information on the social networking. Number two, so trolling is another thing, and three, cyberbullying is there. So a lot of people can spread negative sentiments. So there are many disadvantages using social networking. Now I would like to ask a few questions from the audience. I request the audience. You look so angry.
చాలా హ్యాపీగా ఉంది అండి. ఇక్కడ కూర్చోవడం నాకు చాలా ఇబ్బందిగా ఉంది, బికాస్ నేను అక్కడ ఉండేదాన్ని ఎప్పుడు చాలా హ్యాపీగా ఉంది.